This video presents practical workflow scenarios for expression-defined properties. Expression-defined properties, just as normal properties, have many uses. Let us first activate the Property Manager dialog. All properties listed in the Expression-defined properties group are defined by expressions, as indicated by the default column. Expression-defined properties can be used in schedules. When defining schedule schemes, they can be used either as criteria or as schedule fields. In this example, the door info tag property is displayed as part of the schedule. This expression-defined property assembles a text value from the element ID, home story number, and orientation of the door. Expression-defined properties can be used in labels as well. For example, we can insert the same door info tag property as autotext as part of a label's text. Let's use the text autotext label and associate it to a door. Click the Insert Autotext button of the text editor palette. Please note that only properties applicable to doors are offered for insertion. Select the door info tag property and add it to the label. The label displays the property's value for the door it is associated to. The next scenario is the Find and Select palette. We can use expression-defined properties as criteria in this palette as well. In this example, we use the Wall Has No Openings property, which returns the value of true in case the wall has no doors, windows, or empty openings in it. Using this expression-defined property, we can find and select all walls for which this condition is true. We can similarly use expression-defined properties as criteria in graphic override rules. There is one condition, however. When we click the Add button to select the property, we will see that out of all expression-defined properties, only a few are available. This is because to calculate the value of certain properties, ARCHICAD would have to generate a 3D model from which quantities can be calculated. These properties are not available for selection as criteria in this dialog. In this example, we use the home story is basement and home story is ground floor properties in two separate rules to override the fill of those walls and columns, the base of which is located on these stories. The last use case for expression-defined properties is during collision detection. In this example, as a model auditing measure, we wish to see if any objects were placed inaccurately, so they are partially in any of the partition walls. Wall Width class is an expression-defined property, and for walls with a thickness of less than 150 millimeters, its value is thin. We will look for collisions between walls with this property value and objects. ARCHICAD creates markup entries for the collisions it finds, so that we can highlight and review these collisions to improve our model. These use cases demonstrate the great flexibility and versatility of expression-defined properties. Please watch all clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the capabilities of this new feature of ARCHICAD 22.